Hello everyone, thank you for having me here. It's a great honor. I'm Pratibha Das Hatiborwa and I'm from the Flugelsoft group of companies. So we are a software and IT technology company. We deal with digital marketing, branding of celebrities, brands, etc. So today's topic is how far should we engage in social media and which platform to use. So I'll be talking from the point of view of a digital marketing manager in a company. So soon you all will be managers, and if your department is digital marketing, so how will you promote your brand or your product? Or if suppose you have your own business and clients come to you asking you to promote your brand or your product, so how far will you engage and what should you do? So first thing, as a digital marketing manager, you have to do intense research on what kind of content you're going to use to promote your brand, research on the latest digital marketing trends, research on the kind of audience you're going to promote your product to, and also the time factor, because if you keep frequently posting your stuff on social media, people, you have the risk of losing your customers and your audience. Like Mr. Garg very well said that there is too much of information nowadays, and people are alarmed by the amount of information. So if you keep posting, over posting your stuff, whether be it through a video, you put too long videos, or you put too much of written documentation, written posts, so people get bored and they lose attention. So you have the risk of losing the attention span of your potential customers or the audience. So that is the thing you have to keep in mind. That is, when you're a digital marketing manager, you have to research your audience, the kind of content you're going to use, the time factor, and the latest digital trends. Fine. Then what kind of platform are you going to use for your product or your brand or your business? So first thing is, you need a website. So people should know what your product is about, what you are about. So first thing, you'll have to have your website. So with the help of a website, you are in regular touch with your customers. Your customers, you don't lose your customers, because they can keep, usually what happens, your customers read about your post or check your video and they go. But when you have a website, your customers keep coming back. They get to see reviews about your product, testimonials. There are how-tos, how to operate your product, or more details on your product. And also they can address the issues, their complaints. So you have a long-term connectivity with your customers. So first thing is, you need to have a website. Then secondly, you have to design an email marketing campaign. So with the help of emails, you can send newsletters which talks about the features of your product, or different workshops or different events. So people can keep getting updates about your product. But then again, you have to exercise balance and restraint. You have to see at what frequency you're sending the emails. Too much of emails, and all, you can be diverted to the spam folder. So whether be your Facebook account, you might be unfollowed, or whether be about whether it's a mailing platform like Gmail, Yahoo, you'll be blocked. So there also you have to exercise restraint. Then thirdly, when you're designing your digital marketing plan for your company or business or your client's business, third thing you have to keep in mind is a mobile marketing plan. Nowadays, most people, they don't use the computer, whether they be a homemaker or an office goer or a high-end professional, even your domestic worker, most of the work is done through the mobile. They might be booking a cab or booking a gas or even buying movie tickets through the mobile. So you have to see that your business has a mobile app. It's like mobile friendly. Even if you have a website, you should see that the website is responsive on the mobile. What happens is, the website which works on the desktop, it might not come properly on the mobile. Some contents might be hidden, or you might not get some updates. So you have to have a mobile app for your business. So mobile ad marketing is king. So that is one of the things you have to keep in mind while designing your social marketing plan. Then after that, what is the kind of platform, like the topic says, what kind of platform you should use. So that is very important. So you have to see what is the audience you're having. do you have teenagers? So teenagers, they usually prefer Instagram. They prefer photographs. Do you have academics? Academics prefer Quora because they like to read documentation. They have different queries. They want to know about certain things. So or YouTube has a different kind of how-to tutorials where you can talk about your product. So you have to see the demographics. What kind of demographic? Are they rural people? Are they rural population or the urban population? Or are they teenagers or are they middle-aged group? So depending on that, you have to use the platform. It's not necessary that you use every kind of platform. You have to use the platform which is conducive to your audience, which matches your audience. So that is one of the factor. And the content is very important. Some industries like the travel industry or the hotel industry, if you post most of photographs or videos, you attract your audience. So Instagram really works over there. Then we have YouTube where you can talk about your product. You can put how-to tutorials and so on. Then there is the Facebook where Facebook has a feature called brand promotions. So you can customize the kind of promotion you can use on Facebook depending on the demographics. So accordingly, you have to use the social media for your business, but it should not be like, it should be balanced and it should be related to your audience. It doesn't mean that you have to use YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, all kinds of social media for your business. If Instagram works and it's for younger audience, you can use Instagram. If it's for middle age group, you have content management blogs where you can talk about a product, you can blog about a product. So you have to design your social media as per the audience, the content you're going to use, and the time. The time factor is very relevant because you have the risk of losing the audience with too much of posting. So that is all. Thank you.